We want to travel. We travel a lot for our work, and I'm sure there's a lot of people out there, similar age, similar stage in life, that says, we want to see the world. What do we need to have a full-time life on the road and thrive?
You need to know what you don't want. I don't want a toilet. I don't want a shower. We eliminate a lot of stuff that makes these things big. You repurpose that space for something else.
Hang on a second. Thriving, not showering, not having a toilet, is that really a good option?
Your attitude towards it is to do the shower somewhere else. So I pay a gym subscription. You go there, you shower. There's a towel service. Don't worry about it. I'm more comfortable with that because now I don't need to deal with fresh water. Black tank, I don't need to do with water heating.
I'm not going to get away with that. My wife would like the creature comforts, like the bathroom, like the shower. And let's be fair, when we're on the road and we have that facility at our disposal, we actually use it. It's actually quite comfortable to do it. What I've learned, though, is you do not want something that is going to take you half a day to set up, and you definitely don't want something that's going to really be a challenge to drive and park.
Yeah.
Let's find the nice spots. Let's find out what it takes to make these things work full time. Because
sure.
I'm dead sure not all of them has been built to do exactly that. I'm so glad I'm running into you. I want to ask you a quick question. Because you're one of the go-to guys when we need advice. We've seen a whole lot of people starting to make on-the-road living permanent living.
Yes.
Do you see that same
idea? Definitely. Yeah. The infrastructure is there today. People want that roaming freestyle lifestyle, and the products can do it. And so we're going to see more and more of that as the industry matures and as customers mature.
How does that change your life from a dealer's perspective?
It's a little bit challenging with regards to the serviceability of the unit because you don't have a home base, you don't have a home dealer typically. So I would make sure that people deal with a good service network, whether it's an extended service contract or something like RV Care.
The actual units, what are people going for when they go permanently on the road?
I would say everything in between, and that's the great thing of our industry. There are people with travel trailers and small vehicles to tow them, and big fifth wheels and trucks. Of course, motor homes is the go-to, or what most people think of, but the biggest growth right now is the vans, where I can park it anywhere, I can be downtown, I can be at the music festival, and I've still got my home on wheels, and so that van growth continually going up, up, up.
What would you buy?
I would go to the top of the rack, which is the Class A diesel pusher. You've got the horsepower, you've got good fuel economy, and every luxury you can imagine, just like your home. I mean, dishwashers and washer dryers, and it is a home on wheels.
So go big or go home?
Yeah.
That's a bit of a contrast from the van life, though.
I would change your go big or go home, and I would just say go. Whatever your budget can afford, whatever your lifestyle is, just get out there and enjoy this beautiful country.
If you have to advise a customer that says, I want to do full-timing, what are some of the things I have to look at that needs to be important and included in the unit, being it a trailer or fifth wheel or then your motorhomes?
People will come at us and want to go full-time in a motorhome, but when you really drill into it, they're going to go to a lot, say out in BC, that they maybe own a piece of land. Maybe a motorhome's not the way to go. Maybe they should be in a fifth wheel or a large travel trailer. Because really, what's the point of buying a motorhome with a fantastic powertrain only to let it sit? Whereas 42 states, including Florida, they want to go to Alaska, they want to go across Canada. Well, then clearly a motorhome would probably be the best way to go.
But you have some units here that we're quite interested in. Actually, it's like an A-class, but it's smaller. You can actually fit it in a parking spot in Walmart.
Starting at 30 feet in a Class A motorhome, they're more maneuverable. You can virtually park it and take two stalls at any shopping mall, and it fits perfectly.
I've been doing this over 20 years, and I've seen the change coming in the last couple of years. There's a lot of people with SUVs. There's a lot of people that want to be able to park them in the garage, not pay storage, cheaper gas. A lot of people that have bigger units, and they're downsizing, going smaller.
I'm gaining, but what am I sacrificing? What am I losing?
You're not really missing anything. You have all the amenities in a small trailer is what you would certainly get in a big trailer.
The one cowboy lives in a van. He says he's fine. He can do the gym and he can use the bathroom with the gym and he lives out there. I'm saying no. I'm an A-class owner. We need the bathroom because the wife is there. We need the shower.
Yeah.
We need to be able to clean ourselves properly whenever we're required to be clean, not just when you go to the gym.
Absolutely.
Question is, would the cowboy benefit from this?
Absolutely. Like, to be honest with you, I forgot my deodorant. I've been using this all day.
You just put it down.
Do you see what this thing's costing? And then you ask yourself, is this just fashion, or is there actually a good reason why people would pay this much money for something this small because it's this well constructed? You know what? You can live full time in this thing.
You could.
Is there still this mystique around Airstream? Because from a price point perspective, you look at this, wow. Why would I buy this and not buy one of the other ones?
Well, it's two-sided. It's, you know, the construction of an Airstream trailer is certainly second to none in relation to, you know, other products built in the market. You know, there's a lot of prestige that comes along with owning an Airstream as well. You know, knowing that it's the best travel trailer available in the market, you know, there's nothing else that even compares.
They're also doing the B-classes, which is standing behind you here.
You bet.
And they're right at the top end of the B-classes. Is there a demand for that, or is that just really getting silly?
No, there's a demand. I mean, on this van, for example, you've got the full-timer, but you've also got customers that are using this as their daily drivers to, you know, move people around. You know, there's some models that can seat up to six people. They're using that as a full-time commuter.
How do you as a dealer adjust to that demand for more full-timing? Because it puts some more stress on you, doesn't it?
We're doing mobile service now, where we have a truck that will come to you versus you bringing your unit into the shop, and that's really benefited our full-time customers.
And that's only for Airstream customers?
No, no, that's across the board.
Too honest, you need to sell this. It's a good thing. It's something that nobody's doing, because you know that service is a massive issue in this industry.
It can be. Yeah. Yep. You know, anything we can do to make it easier for the customer is the end goal.
That's why you got the Airstream.
You bet.
This is obviously a great deal. Not even Ford gives you this deal on their transits. No. You know that?
Yeah. At the Calgary RV Show, we're offering it at $94,900. So we're under $100,000 for a full van conversion, which is something, like you say, you don't see that very often.
Nobody's doing that. Airstream, nothing against Airstream. Yep. I mean, it's a phenomenal one. But I don't have $200,000 for that job.
We pride ourselves on having a good selection of vans. So we have Winnebago vans. So we have the Era, which competes with that Airstream. So we wanted to have a good scale of vans, and this is where the scale starts. And so that's why we built this, is to focus in on, hey, you know, there's a chunk of the market of what people are looking for out there, and not there. So that's why AML came up with this guy, is to fit in at a price point below everyone else, still give you a full proper van conversion, and get more of them into the market.
The build quality. What am I giving away? What am I losing by, you know, $50,000 on the price tag?
You know what? When you're looking at like an Airstream or an Era, obviously the first comparison is the chassis. So on those two coaches, you're looking at a Mercedes diesel chassis, whereas this, you're looking at the Ford Transit chassis with the gasoline engine. So that's a huge price point difference right there. Now, it's becoming a more prevalent chassis, and it also is lovely because the Ford dealer network. So you can get this serviced at any Ford dealer. Whereas with a Mercedes, you have to find a Mercedes dealer.
Yeah, I know. This is 150 on an oil change. The Mercedes, you 450 on an oil change. Yep. I know. It's hurting me every time. Yep. I go there with my B-Class. Now, but in terms of facilities, you still got your toilet, you still have a shower, you still have your water tanks. So nothing really lost in that regard, is it?
No, nope, it's full feature. You have everything that you need, and not equip you with things that you don't need.
Dean, here's a question that comes up for us often, because your units are so lovely. Okay. We're going to show people how great they are. But do people actually live in these things full time?
We have some, yeah. You know what? We have probably, you know, we do a rally every year in September at our factory, and we probably have, what, 100 coaches come, so 200 people. I think last year, did we have six full timers, six out of 100, you know, full timing. You know, they just follow the sun. What a beautiful life. And more and more.
When you say more and more, it obviously then it's a market trend. Things,
yes,
things are looking up there.
Yes.
And I think it might be because the baby boomers are moving on, and some of our new generation,
yep,
is moving in.
Correct.
And we want some more flexibility and freedom.
Correct.
Why your unit, not something else?
Because we're small, we're green, clean running diesel, right? Great fuel economy. Solar up on the roof, you know, self-contained with generators and everything. You want to go to all over the place. You want to be as small and stealth as you can. I think this is the prime size, because it gives you storage. It gives you a dry bathroom, stand-up shower. It gives you room. Other than, you know, the vans are great, right? But they're a little bit tight. This just is the next step up.
You can really fit all of that in this?
We can, yeah.
The one thing we've learned in the RV industry is that the dealerships don't want to service other people's units. Like, you have to sort of always go back to the mothership when you get it. Yeah. Is that a challenge with leisure vans?
You know what? I think it's a challenge in the industry. The industry is busy. I think last year they built more RVs than ever in the history of the RV business, like 480,000 RVs. This year they're projecting over 500,000 RVs. So dealerships are busy. There's no question. And, you know, we want that selling dealer to look after, you know, our customer. Now, if you're on the road, we provide a 1-800 toll roadside assistance program. You dial 1-800 number, they'll get you service anywhere where you are. So we pay for that service for the first 2 years. You can renew that after. But yeah, RV service is definitely is a problem.
These units, they seem to be the workhorse of the trailer business.
Yes.
People still buy these because there's all fancy stuff out there.
Well, this is the thing. If you go to an aluminum body, you usually end up saving about $3,000, maybe $4,000.
These things like Central Vac and all the beautiful things they tell you that you have in your house, now you can have it in a trailer. Should you concern with those things? Are they important when you actually live in it, or is it just really to check the boxes on the sales chart?
So the more value they get for the dollar, the more inclined they are to buy it. Try to give you as much information as we can so you can make an informed decision as to what trailer you can buy, or should buy, and how to use them.
When you're full-time on the road, you need to have an address, because you need to get your mail there, you need to pay your taxes there, you need to... Medical aid's an important thing. How are you doing, sir?
Pretty good, how are you?
Can I get away with this as a residence, a place where I reside when I'm full-timing on the road, or do I still have to have a house somewhere else?
You can't live here. There can't be a full-time resident. It's an RV resort. People have access all the time, but the water and sewer is shallow, so it doesn't run in the wintertime. So there's no place other than we do have the facility in the middle, but no, can't be used for a full-time resident.
We are trying to work out something about people that go on the road permanently,
okay,
or full-timers.
Yep.
Not the van lifers, not the dwellers, the full-timers, not the snowbirds.
Okay.
Which is different.
The guys that move place to place all the time.
Move place to place all the time. Are you a place that caters for people like us?
To be honest with you, no, we're not. These are all these lots here are titled and deeded. They're for sale. It's not a rental situation.
This could be a home base, though.
It could be a home base, absolutely.
But because it's in the U.S., I'm going to pay taxes.
Yep, you do. You pay property tax.
Right?
Yeah.
And if I spend too much time there, they're going to come after my income as well.
Well, I'm worried about it.
I heard people are not building RV resorts anymore. Is that true or not?
Oh, no. Park Bridge is always looking to expand and always looking for different opportunities in every province. So right now we have four properties in BC, and those ones are open year-round. And then we have two properties in Alberta, and those are seasonal. So a person would come in, they'd rent a spot, and it'd be theirs for the whole year.
Darcy, is it only rental, or do you guys sell into the resorts as well? Like,
No, we're strictly a rental property. Yeah, that way people aren't locked into a long-term commitment. They can come for a season, they can come for a weekend. Price ranges between $35,000 to $4,000 for the year, which is pretty reasonable.
Wow, that's very reasonable.
Yeah.
Membership? Is there a membership I need to join?
There's no membership fees. We're the original True Camping. You don't have to sign up, you just phone up, look for a spot you like, and then put your deposit down and move in.
You full?
Not yet.
Let's take the journey. Let's see what we like, what we don't like, what works. I want to see if your gym thing is going to do the trick or not. And we compare. Yeah. The whole idea about this lifestyle is you can be in places you want to be, not the places you have to be.
One prereq.
Yeah.
You've got to eat well.
But, you know, good friends, good barbecue, good beer. What else do you need?
That's all you need. Good whiskey.
Good whiskey. Good whiskey. Like that one. And, you know, let the wheels roll.